expectations. Of course the CBO is going to say, if you're not going to force people to buy something they don't want to buy, they won't buy it. But at the same time, they're saying our reforms will kick in and lower premiums and make healthcare therefore more accessible.
More accessible. This is the argument that you have. And they've said this for years. Ideologically, philosophically, consistent, free market. Government's not going to make you. You're not banned in. You're going to have options out there. But if you choose not to get health insurance, that's what I'm going to say.
And that's a fine argument to make, but the problem is you do need to have a certain number of people in the marketplace. And so the Democratic position was to require them to do so. Republicans are arguing that the sheer cost and accessibility will draw people in. But there's a lot of skepticism around that, particularly for younger, healthy people, which have been actually a hard time to the Obamacare system, even with the mandate. So without that pressure on, how will you compel those people to buy a plan? That is a huge unanswered question. And without answering that question, a lot of these other factors that Ryan is talking about are just much less certain.
And access doesn't mean affordable. That's the other thing. I mean, people might drop off because they can't afford what they're going to have to pay under this new plan. And that's a big problem for Republicans if these people are ending up using the emergency room again as their main source of health care.
And this idea that health insurance companies are going to compete to take care of poor people who are very sick, might have heart disease or diabetes, it's very expensive. And I think people have.